Evening folks, this is BestInSlot and welcome back to the Return to Jurassic Park DLC for Jurassic World Evolution. In today's video, we're going to try to complete Mission 6 New Attractions. They want us to bring Compsognathus into the park. Now, I have just done my research on them and I've done my dig sites, so I've got 100% on the compi. So all we have to do now is make an exhibit. No, we don't. We've got one right here. So all we have to do now is start building them and funneling in to that right hand side. Now we do need 5 of them, so let's make a default one, but then let's get a little funky with the colouring. I am starting to unlock I was about to say I'm starting to unlock all the different skin colours, but apparently none of the compi ones, as it happens. They go so quick. Gee, look at that. Zoom. What value is a compi? 15, that's not that surprising. Just gonna go back into research. Try to get some more skins. What would a compi? Compi and nope. Just focus on the compi ones for now. Compi, cool. I have to get rid of this annoying little tick. There we go. And there we go. So I've got my Stegosaurus maxed out as well, so we can bring some of those in, and we'll just have to pick something else. I think herbivores are definitely the best bet. Apatosaurus is done, we should definitely get some of those as well. Coryphosaurus, I call it. I don't call it Coryphosaurus. Stop letting other people contaminate your brain. Let's get these compies delivered. Very exciting. We also have no food or water. We'll fix that. Actually, I'm not convinced, now that I think about it, that the pachycephalosaurs have water either. So we'll have to check that in a moment. It's a shame it's a little bit dark and spooky. Well, dusky. Because the compies are going to be pretty much impossible to see anyway, so it would have been nice to get some daytime. But hey-ho. There we go, beautiful, beautiful. Let's get that research going again. Compi and compi. So we'll just start breeding a couple of the new skin ones as well. Why the devil not, eh? So we've got woodland. I think the compi social need is like 1 to 30 or something like that. So we can play around a lot with this. Woodland and rainforest, and we'll get a couple more in a moment. You do have water. You've got water. You've got water, but you actually don't have food. That's my bad. I am the big... No, you do have food. It's right there. Oh, it's because you're on top of it. You've got water, and you've got food. You've got food. Yeah, everyone's okay. Never mind. We can also get jungle. And we can get tundra. Somewhere. There it is. I swear the research is flying by, it really is. Nope. Yep. So that, I think, is all the compi skins. So we'll just grab ourselves the vivid compi, and then we'll shuffle them all over, and we'll have 5 brand new brightly coloured compis to hopefully get us a little bit of nice rating as well, and then we'll work on the Stegosaurus. Cool. And it's also going to be really good for our profit. You don't have food or water. You will die in that situation, my friends, so let's give them a feeder. And let's get them a little bit moist. There we go, nice moist compi. Don't know about you guys, but personally that's what I want for my dinosaurs. Moistness. What was the new one? Vivid, wasn't it? Is it unlocked? Yes, there we go.
Because our hands aren't full enough with walking and crawling dinosaurs, now you want dinosaurs that fly?
They're reptiles, actually. And just imagine what it would be like to witness them taking flight. Within a secured enclosure, of course. Now, I just need to find Cabot. He seems to have flown the coop.
Which these dinosaurs, reptiles, can never do. Like, ever. And you know that for a fact. Right, John?
A secured aviary, Dr. Malvin. What goes in, stays in.
Unless there's a storm.
John, what exactly goes in?
Cool. Research item from Research Center Aviary. Research item, Research Center Pteranodon.
We're raising dinosaurs and capital around here. That's a winning combination. In fact, that's the secret truth of Jurassic Park. Without one, there can't be the other.
It's funny, in the story, Cabot has disappeared somewhere. We have no idea where Cabot is, but I can still get missions from him, so he still has to pop his little head up. We need 5 Stego. I forgot how much of a pain in the ass the Stego is, but it means we can mess around some skins. So we've got 1997 pattern A. Let's see what else we've got. How many new skins do we have for the stacker? We've got 997, 997 A, C, D, E. I believe one of them is tied to a challenge mode, unfortunately. Which I will try to get done before the skin videos, but no promises. Get all these stegos ready to go. This is going to be so good for our park rating. See that I didn't get right? I think so. Cool, we get to see all the skins. Right then, to the research screen. We are looking for Pteranodon. Beautiful. I see you, Rexy. And we're looking for the aviary double. Awesome. Everything is cool. Everything is cool. We could also do with a new contract. It's taking a long time. Talk to me, Cabot.
I can't believe that we get to work with dinosaurs. Or that you get to work with me. Just kidding. Or am I? Maybe this new contract will help clarify things. For both of us.
Isn't that really cool? That's the, Not roll. I assume that's the Vivid Compi. Very nice. Actually, it's purple, which is always a nice surprise. Then they get the colours correct. Let's see if we can find another one. Any other compies wanna... Oh. No. Oh. There we go. Oh, they are beautiful. They're really hard to see, but they do look awesome. Who's this one? Who's this one? Who's this one? Who's this one? I know, they've all got this kind of like little stripe patterning, which looks quite nice. Yeah, they're near enough impossible to get a close look at. We'll wait till daytime and we'll try again, but pretty cool. Oh, look at that one. Is that the rainforest one? It's very blue, so I assume so. That's beautiful. Awesome. Yeah, exciting. Jurassic Gifts has been... Oh, no. Now how will people buy my overpriced tat? Repair it, you fools. I'm going to also add a new team. And we're going to get some scheduling. And we're going to send these out. Get filling these feeders in. All the way around, buddy. We'll just wait till they get over there and we'll do some more. Now, with that done, I think we need to start digging for the Pteranodon. Oh, look, it's another...
Dr. Grant, the aviary research is complete. And you believe in the findings? As much as I believe in anything here, which is to say, no. But the engineers are confident in the design. I mean, they were before, too, so, you know, we've got that to fall back on.
Okay, we'll get this aviary built, powered, and connected to the rest of the park. Then we'll be able to have one of Ellie's favorites, available for study and on display.
We're doing it, Alan. We're all doing it.
Doing what?
Proving Hammond right.
I love that. He knows what's going on, and he's still part of it. You can incubate and release Pteranodons at an aviary. You can increase the number of Pteranodons that can be supported by an aviary in the info panel. Storm damaged aviaries risk releasing Pteranodons into the wild.
Your
I really want to see that.
Excellent.
Thank you. Cheers, Cabot. You're a good egg. Ah, we do need new power. I'm really running out of room more than anything else, unfortunately. We're going to build another power station. I'm hoping I don't need anything else, basically, that this is fine at this point. Like, I don't have to build anything around here because it's just not going to fit, quite frankly. Also, how cool is this aviary building? Look at that. Chugga, 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 chugga. Boop. And it'll start to disappear at the side, maybe. I really like that tiered sort of design. This is always one of my favorite animations. Bit messy at the top. That's okay. I'll forgive him. Right then. So, are my stegos... No, stegos are nearly done. We've got the power station on the way. That'll be done. Hopefully that's going to help us with the park rating and such. Yet another goddamn hotel. Yeah, I didn't really plan this area out that well, I'll admit. Like, from the get-go, it's a little bit haphazard. So, it's proving a little difficult to squeeze everything in. It still looks fine, it really does, but it's a little bit tight.
I can't wait to see them fly.
I hope our guests share your enthusiasm, my dear Dr. Sattler.
Pteranodons. Alan, Pteranodons. Can you believe it?
How many times has that question been asked on this island?
It's not how many times it's been asked, Dr. Grant, but how many times it's been answered. Today, Jurassic Park takes flight.
It's really cool. This whole building is awesome. It really is. All these little viewpoints dotted around the whole thing. You can even go down here, right down here at the bottom. You can see that directly across from the aviary. Also like a little sort of vehicle entrance station where they'd come in to like feed them, stuff like that, I assume. Do you actually ever go inside the building? You don't actually go inside the viewing area, oddly enough. And there's 9 camera views and none of them are in the viewing area. That's odd. But still, it's a really great looking place. You know, there's droppings, there's caged walkways. Those are in order of importance. Yeah, it's awesome. It really is. I'm very, very excited. I've got a couple pieces of amber to kick things off, which is good stuff. So, let's get hunting for more T-Don, T-Bones. T-Dog, and whilst that's going on, we're going to pump out some stegos. Are they going to be okay living here? What's your population? 3, 4, 9. They should be fine. Come on, boys. Girls. I don't know. I'm always a little unsure. Like, what gender do I refer to? It doesn't really matter. I'm sure they're not going to be offended, but...
Well, I can, actually, because I knew you'd get the job done.
I've always wanted Ellie Sattler to tell me I was a good person. All my dreams are coming true. Let's go have another contract. Let's keep working for Hammond, if possible.
We've had enough big yikes. Details. We can move things along with this next contract.
Not the easiest looking little guest card. That's like double the last one they wanted from me, but we'll see what we can do. Obviously, adding the Pteranodons is going to be a big increase. We need to release Pteranodons at the aviary to reach a combined rating of 400. Interestingly enough, when I last played the game, that was actually at 500, if I recall correctly, which I inevitably don't. Okay, visibility. Really? Wait, that's a thing? Does visibility actually count towards... See, it suggests that visibility counts towards park rating, but restrooms are at 66, shopping ratings at 75. That's not great anyway, so that could be the... I don't know, that's odd. Also, it's saying not great visibility, but... Okay, visibility. My visibility is 88%. I think that's pretty good. What's going on with the restroom then? Why are people fuming at me? Oh, that's why. These are doing nothing but cost me moolah. Don't know how I'm gonna... I really have not laid this out well at all. I think if I delete this path here... Might be able to squeeze one in there. Eh? Yeah, cheeky. I mean, it isn't... It's proving difficult to squeeze everything in and stuff like that, but I will say it's got a very natural, open kind of feel to it, which is very classic Jurassic Park. It's very much not the rigidity that you'd associate with, say, Jurassic World, so that's my excuse, and I'm sticking to it, okay? I'll go check on the stegos in a moment. How are we doing over here? Over here? Yeah, on the way, so whilst that's going on, although this is pause gameplay, so don't know what I'm about. I am going to wait for 100%. I can't not wait for 100%. It'll just upset me to my core. Come on, Smokey. Come on, Smokey. Come on, buddy. Who's a good dick sight? You're a good dick sight. Oh, sweet. You are a good dick sight. Okay, so we will skip forward a little bit, folks. I will get the Pteranodons up to 100, and then we will release them into the aviary for the first time. Actually, saying that, we do have some stegos to look at first. So let's find number one. There she is. Oh, is she? That's so much better. It's just that the new normal maps are fantastic. The beak looks amazing. The new color scheme. The head shape, I believe, has changed. We're going to do some like direct comparisons between the dinosaurs at a later date. But yeah, it looks amazing. Check out the other skins. That was quite nice. It's got like this purplish-gray kind of tint. It's a little hard to tell at the moment because of the time of day, but not bad. Got like a bit more of a reddish brown one, bit of a dull one there, and what have we got over here? Very nice, a bit of green and brown at play. Very cool. We're sent to Jurassic Park, you do make me happy. You can have a look at the compies, it's a bit bright now, you just can't see them. Look at him! It's tiny! Hanging around the raptor pen, inside the raptor pen, the cheeky little so-so. Cannot see a bloody thing. I really like this one though. I think that's the rainforest one. That's kind of a subtle blue. Isn't it really good? I gotta say, like, I know it's tiny. It's really hard to see unless you kind of do this in the first place, but the texture work in the normal maps and the... I mean, look at that colour difference there in the neck. It's all very... Honestly, I think it's actually one of the better designed dinosaurs in total. It might be easier to do because of the small scale, but the colours and the texturing is actually really top-notch. Makes me very erotically happy. So, right, as I said, we are going to wait for the fossils. Yeah, so we'll wait till that's 100%, and then we will add them into the park, which is pretty bloody hype. Just a few loot boxes later, we are finished. We are ready to go with our aviary. So the first thing we want to do, I think, is upgrade our slot. We're going to upgrade the incubation speed. Success rate is pretty pointless when it comes to the aviary, as long as you have 100% genome, because you can't genetically modify the pteranodons beyond their skin. How do I update this? Six mini T-dons. Let's get my T-dons. So at the moment, you click incubate and it's automatically a pteranodon. I personally don't think we're ever going to... Look at this, isn't it cool? I personally don't ever think we're going to get a new thing for the aviary. Just because it is a DLC building and a lot of people wouldn't have access to it. It just seems unlikely to me. Never say never. But given how they've set this up, it would actually be really easy to do. So there is that possibility for the future. Either way, six brand new pteranodons in the park. That's going to do wonders for our guest count, for our profit, and for indeed for our island rating, which is looking pretty good anyway. Things are coming together. Things are going very well. Something's going to go disastrously wrong. I'm waiting for it. It's you, isn't it? They're conspiring against me. I love that. Love that skin. I was about to call you a pteranodon. Not that likely. It is a great skin, though. I still... Like, that noise is really obnoxious, but still, where's the brachies at? There's my trike boys roaming together. With some of them with their little custom skins. Where are my brachies? You should be able to see them from miles away. It's a blooming brachiosaurus. Seriously? Oh, they're over here. Ah! The herding mechanic is really cool, but it does make your dinosaurs... It means, generally speaking, your dinosaurs will actually... not be that spread out. Usually they'd like separate from each other and spread out across your entire exhibit. That happens less now, which is definitely more realistic. I definitely prefer it. I say now, the herding update was in like December, so. What have we got on here? We have Pachycephalosaurus and Ankylosaurus, both utterly useless. Good stuff. I'm gonna keep working on this Coryphosaurus. Just gotta keep working on our dino rating. Like I said, we only need, I believe, 4 stars in order to, unlock the thing that I'm trying to unlock. I can't remember what it is. It's something. I think it's this map on sandbox and challenge mode, but I'm not 100% sure. We will also have to go over to Isla Sauna and do the same thing. Also think there may be some reputation unlocks over there, which we'd of course want to check out. How are we doing? Oh, we're ready. Here we go, folks. Our first pteranodon. Very cool.
See, that wasn't so bad. It was rather good, in fact.
There it is. Big rock.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are pleased to welcome a pteranodon to the park.
Doesn't it look great? This is actually the same animation we saw during the, whatchamacallit? I can't remember that preview of the other day. Let's release more of them. This is the alpine pattern. Oh, you can move this. Oh, sweet.
The islands could use a bit of good news right about now, and you have provided it.
There we go, alpine pattern. Very cool, very sexy. Love that from the cage side. It just makes everything cooler for me for some reason. We're going to rank these as we go. I prefer the default to the alpine so far. What's this? This is rainforest. Rainforest is pretty cool. Where is he? He's there. He's lurking in the darkness. And he's off. Now, I made a little mistake talking about this. When I saw this, I thought this had a yellow patterning around the eye. I believe this is meant to look like the Lost World's Jurassic Park version of the pteranodon, which you barely see.
Either way, way to make it happen.
You glimpse it right at the end of the film, you really do. But I believe it had this kind of light tealish blue kind of effect. Now, just what... Let's grab our new fossils. Love, 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 love. Lots of Cory. Lots of money. I'm absolutely loaded. money hasn't been a... I've not thought about it. Not once. It's odd. Let's check our contracts and we'll work for someone. When it pops up. When this goes away. Come on. Go away. Hammond, talk to me.
I take care of the people who take care of me and my dinosaurs. This contract is your chance. I think you should take it.
Jungle pattern. And he's off. Somewhere. There we go. Does that look jungly? Yeah, we got that kind of... Oh, that's pretty cool, actually. That kind of crimson colour around the eye. I will say I think I still like the default one more than the others, but that's pretty cool. We have wetland. We're expecting some sort of greens and yellows popping up. It is terrifying. It's lurking there in the darkness. Oh, that's cool. You can see the green already. And then the flying to your face, which is fun for the whole family. Yeah, it's quite nice, actually.
We are pleased to welcome a pteranodon to the park.
One more to go. This is the coastal. So it should be brownish, blackish, greyish kind of colours. Oh lord, he's coming. Oh lord, he's gone. Oh, buddy. I like that one as well. That one's pretty cool as well. Actually, that's pretty poor with the yellow around the eyes. Dead dinosaur. Mission 6 completed, baby! Sorry. Right, so I've actually done that mission before as well. I did that one during the Frontier event. I wasn't allowed to record it at the time. So, final mission now, and I've never seen this one. Mission 7. Let's go.
At this point, we're just going to continue to add to the populations, dinosaurs and humans, increase the density and capacity of both. It's a miracle. Two creatures from the same place, but different worlds.
The dream, Dr. Malcolm. The dream of dinosaurs once again roaming the Earth. Belief pays off.
Ellie, the dinosaurs went extinct because they were supposed to. Survival of the fittest, nature's law. But a new god has spoken. He wears a white cabana shirt and walks with a cane. This is John Hammond's world now. We're just surviving in it, marking time until we're not.
We didn't suffer in vain, Ian. Something good and wonderful came out of this. Living dinosaurs.
Yeah, good. Wonderful. The chaos is coming, Dr. Sattler, but I do admire your optimism.
I'm curious. Is chaos coming? Malcolm has been saying for this whole thing that as well as things are going, as hard as everyone's trying to keep things together, that this is not sustainable, that something is going to go wrong. Is he just being typical negative Malcolm? Or, oh, hello. Very cool. Or is it true? Is something terrible actually going to happen? I'm very curious. Also, this is how we unlock the Jurassic Park stuff for Challenge Mode and the campaign, which is pretty cool as well. Right then, we are here for Tyrannosaurus Rex. What fence do I have? Do I have a decent fence? I have an electrified cable fence. Is that my best bet? It must be. When do we get the better fence?
Ah. This is a place full of opportunities.
At the end of the day, I do want to finish all of these.
Dinosaur, we are only scratching the surface. But studying dinosaurs means digging deeper. It did before Jurassic Park, even more so now. Take a look at this contract, then dig.
That's the one I won. Oh, God.
This contract? We can keep it just between you and me. I've had enough of doubting PhDs to last a millennia, thank you very much.
I could be a PhD, Mr. Hammond. Why are you making these assumptions about me? I have a pretty huge dinosaur. Right, achieve facility rating. Why is that fallen? If you talk to me about my goddamn capacity one more time... Why do I need so many hotels? This is insane. There's no room. Where are they meant to go? There's no space for it. Right, let's go in there. Okay, turns out there's tons of space. That's not the point. I want to complain, I'm going to complain. Right. Where are we going to put a T-Rex? Oh, we should also get rid of this dead dinosaur. All my galleys are starting to die off a little bit, which is a shame. Oh, and over there. Jesus Christ, okay. All over the park, gallimimuses mysteriously start to die. What we're going to do is we're going to do an electrified cable fence, and we're going to drag it right here along the tour vehicle. And this is going to be our T-Rex paddock. Right along there, just like in the film. We'll put the little bathroom in and everything. It's going to be really cool. don't want the exhibit to be unnecessarily big just because you want the T-Rex to actually come and hang around by the fence, essentially. And what we'll do is we'll clear the trees just on this side. Not completely, but a little bit. That's going to look awesome. And we need... Okay, let's get ourselves set up. Let's give them a goat feeder. A little bit of water. Lots of water. What's going on here? Desist! Desist, game! Oh, God. Everything's a travesty. Everything is sad. Let's flatten that back down. No. No. Right, okay. Big. Flat. Okay. Everything is ruined. Everything is a disaster. Oh, my God. Everything is pain. Life is pain. Okay, we're going to flatten this way instead. That's better. Okay, we just do that, and then we smooth it out. Just over here. And we've got a little bit of a ditch to the left, and that's cool because that is just like in the film anyway. It should be a massive ditch, but still. What is the water? Oh, I hate the water in this game sometimes. Okay, cool. We are ready to go with our T-Rex. Who? Stop. Stop. Wait, why are you dead? Oh, you're not dead. You've got E. coli. Yeah, same thing. Okay, not really the same thing. You're dead. It's just Gallimimus is really dying of old age all over the park. That's actually a problem because I don't believe I've got Gallimimus ready to go. But hey ho. What do you need? Shopping is pretty low, actually. We can work on that. First of all, T-Rex. Priorities in order. What'd you say? We have a T-Rex! You have to do it in a slightly squeaky voice. Okay. T-Rex time! Facility rating, working on. Dinosaur rating, T-Rex will help. Guest count, dinosaur will help. These do feel like they're going to go rather slowly, must be said. But we're getting there. What am I doing with my life? Oh, yeah, shopping. Where do we need shopping? There and over here. That makes sense. We've added this whole new big area over here, and you tend to need shops, and you tend to need restrooms, and you tend to need all that kind of stuff in the area. So let's just put in all three buildings. That's a gift. Let's get a cafe. And let's get a restroom. Eh? Eh, come on. You know you are. If it doesn't snap, it actually can fit in there. You can see it. Look at that. Beautiful.
I see that my belief in you has merit. Never a doubt.
5 stars, baby!
Royalty is a two-way street. You've done so much to help me that I'd like to return the favor. You might even call it a gift.
It's a good egg, Hammond. Fake Hammond. I love fake Hammond. Nine, Hammond, stop it. I take everything back. You're a terrible person. What have we got here? Research cost? Yeah, okay. New viable genome, baby. Oh, Lord, she's coming. Really excited about the T-Rex. Mainly because I want to see the skins. I want to see the blue Rex. I haven't seen it. I know it got rumoured and some people commented about it and stuff like that. And of course, there was those stupid leaks. Big dumb idea, just saying. You're really taking your time here. What are you doing? You've come stuck on a built. Okay, I'm just going to... Does that help? Do you reckon you can handle it now? Yeah, dummy. Kids these days. Reckon we can put a fence in that gap there. You should see them start to turn in that direction instead. Especially if I... They can drive through trees so much easier than we can. It's a hate crime, I tell you. But we got our guest count. Very cool. Just got to maintain that for a little bit. T-Rex is climbing at an appropriate rate. Everything's looking pretty good. I'm a little nervous. Malcolm's been he's been warning us, and annoyingly, Malcolm does tend to be right. Dinosaur rating's going to be a little tricky. Facility rating maxed. I'm hoping that'll do now. No more hotels, no more anything. But it does look pretty nice, doesn't it? It's got this really cool, like, little village kind of feel to it. Very Jurassic Park. It maybe needs some trees. Can we get some trees in there? One or two, yeah. You know, the tour vehicles, you're walking down, you're going to go grab Jurassic Gifts, you're going to go get like a $50 tiny stuffed Triceratops, and you're walking along, you look to your left and you see the tour vehicles waiting or heading off on their journey to be eaten by Tyrannosaurus Rexes and Velociraptors and such. It's fun for the whole family. Returning to base? No, you're not. Come back. Adding to the list. And yes, another dead Gallimimus. Because this is now the world we live in. Maybe my Gallimimus is maxed out. Let me check. No, it's not even 50%. Sweet. It's kind of a pain in the ass. C'est la vie.
This contract could provide us with important new information. And in this evolving reality of humans and dinosaurs sharing the same space, we need all the knowledge we can get.
I agree. I got you, buddy. Don't you worry about it. Alright then. We'll skip forward a little bit once more until the T-Rex is at 100%, basically. Tyrannosaurus Rex then, folks. 100%, there we go. I've gone for the 2001 pattern just because I thought we'd mix things up a little bit. We're going to get him shuffled over here. Really excited to see this.
We got a huge problem.
Oh.
The raptors, their pens are open and the emergency bunkers have been disabled.
You suspect more sabotage?
I have zero doubts, John.
And where in the hell is Cabot?
You think he's involved in this, John?
Most certainly not. Do you?
Let's not rule anything or anyone out.
Perhaps that is wise.
This time we have to stop the bleeding first. Or at least keep it to a minimum.
Yes. Go. Whatever it takes.
You've seen the reports, Ian.
So no sugarcoating. Just how bad is it?
Wild raptors, alpha predators, running free in the park. Probably hunting.
Definitely hunting.
And our guests are their most obvious prey.
We can try and trank them.
Agreed. And let's tell John to close the park down before the panic sets in.
It's too late for that, Dr. Sattler. Closing would only make things worse.
Oh,
suddenly
no.
People together and creating bigger targets. Besides, closing the park. Hammond would never go for it.
Where have I seen and lived
Will
this
you,
story before?
What are you doing?
That's right.
Oh, he's
I
on the move.
It was on this very spot.
Then we'll tranquilize them. It'll work. It has to.
I'm gonna do it manually. I'm gonna be a baller. Let's go! Here I come to wreck
the
day!
I'm all ears.
These raptors have been modified. Genetically, I mean.
Oh.
So, what, you're saying that they're mutants?
They're unique expressions of a specific strain of
raptor. No.
So, mutants.
Whoever's behind the hacks and sabotage did something to make the dinosaurs immune to sedation.
Someone is attacking Jurassic Park from within.
And using its inhabitants to do it.
Then that is how we'll save it.
What do you have in mind, Ellie?
The T-Rex. We turn her loose.
No. No, let's not do that.
Chaos, Ian. Isn't that what you wanted?
Malcolm, it saved us before. She'll want to establish dominance immediately, which means she's going to go after the raptors.
Not like this.
Didn't John Hammond tell you whatever it takes? Well, this is what it takes. A T-Rex.
I hate this place.
I don't blame you, Malcolm, buddy. I don't blame you. Folks, I hate to be a blue baller, but this is a good time to end things. In the next video, we're going to finish off Mission 7, and indeed, by the looks of things, the entire campaign. The raptors are loose in the park, eating my beloved humans. Can the T-Rex take them out, and then can we wrestle back control of Jurassic Park? Where is Cabot, and who is sabotaging the park? Is it Cabot? That seems like too neat a bow. We'll have to wait and find out in what is probably the final episode. Thank you so much for joining me. Hit the like button if you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.